Dear friends,
this is George Lees, following on from the video I made on the horrendous issues of the killing of the Archduke and the Archduke's sons in what became the Rothschilds' shooting lodge and the whole of the Rothschilds' Austria. Today I'm going to extend that. It's probably a less sensational video, but every one of the jokes they make is sick. Every one of the mansions that they have is named after tragedies, warmongering, Hitler's commanders-in-chief, and the heads of the EU as that emerges. And this is the song that explains part of the Rumpelstiltskin story and von Rompuy, the head of the EU and the central bank in Frankfurt, where the Rothschilds came from. So, the Black Balloon story is, sadly, in the stories written by the Grimm brothers from Göttingen. That's Professor Grimm and his brother, Professor Grimm, from Göttingen University, the warmongering place that is the joke that there is no God any longer. Yeah, and the story about this woman is that a dwarf came into her presence. That's like the Jewish angels Gabriel, yeah, coming down to meet Joseph, yeah, and giving them the instructions to have God's baby. It's the same story really, because the God in Germany is the king or the Königsberg story, yeah, and that's Königsberg Asset Park in Bruges for the Belgian and the massive EU scams. Okay, his name is von Rompuy, yeah, it's quite a derivatized leap from Rumpelstiltskin, yeah, but the end of his name is the pi word for the piezo joke, yeah, and so let's take you into the images. The music is absolutely lovely. That was Hayley Westenra singing "Who Painted the Moon Black and When I Lost Your Love." So this woman, because she listens to Rumpelstiltskin, who visits her in the night, like the angel Gabriel visited Maria. Mary, sorry, yeah, it's all the same joke. Yeah, and so this one, to earn the kingdom, has to take bales of straw and to weave them into the bundles of gold. And when she does that first for the successful time, she has a small amount of straw in her room, and when she wakes up in the morning, the dwarf has turned it to gold. Yeah, when they extend that to having vast, I forget what you call farm buildings, but sleeping in the straw is in the El Cid joke. All of the stuff about the Barclay brothers and the fields of gold, yeah, is just the straw man joke. And all of the grim fairy tales become the Aryan master races, leading to how the whole world gets stolen by the same family. Okay, let's take you now right back into the archive for the Rothschilds, and I'll show you now some of the highlights of what happens outside the us. So that's the Rumpelstiltskin story and the goose. The story about the geese and the goose stepping, yeah, and the launch of World War I and World War II out of Austro-Hungary, which by the time World War II comes along totally belongs to the Rothschild family out of Bavaria, because of the killing of the Archduke and the launch of World War I and the killing of 80 million global citizens for their greed. Okay, what can I show you next? I mentioned my colleague and the launch in those massive genocides of the nerve gases. So let me show you the family tree for the Rothschilds with the Potters in it. There it is. Okay, there is. There is Philippe Georges de Rothschild. Yeah. Born 1902, died in 1988. Yeah, he's married to Elizabeth de Chambord, Comtesse, 1907 to 1945. Yeah, and his second wife from 1954 is Pauline Fairfax Potter, who lived right up to 1976. And I believe she will have been the wife of Dr. Potter, yeah, or the daughter of Dr. Potter, my colleague at Rothamsted Research Station. When I was working on insecticides and toxicology, but they, for years and decades since World War I, Rothamsted has been the experts in nerve gases, and that's why I was able to give lectures on sarin and the toxins and all of the toxins that were used in the massive genocides in World War II. Let me show you some pictures. Okay, and right next door I met a woman in Berkhamsted, right next to Rothamsted, who was called Nadine Schneider. She is a German profiteering company, but they now live in California. Yeah, my first girlfriend. I almost died in a car crash when I was fondling her thigh. Right next to the crime scene for the Douglas Holmes of Coldstream. Yeah, that is the massive estate where Douglas Holmes has the massive scans that he was interested in preserving Africa's future. Yeah, and that's the man who carpet bombed the Garden of Eden, which is the Garden of Eden in the Bible fraud. Yeah, it's up, and there's the Teresa name that came up in yesterday's video, another name for one of the Rothschilds' massive mansions. Okay, and all the links to the Fairfaxes of the cemetery in Naples, yeah, and the links to the Pisos, yeah, with the yeah, it just keeps coming in. Okay, and it's the same families that run all of the death camps, all of the genocides, yeah, and they're in the family tree as Hill and Hirsch, yeah, and it's absolutely tragic. And all of the Jesus joke is all through it. Okay, that's the American wing. Right then, and it's just fascinating. And there's the Matilda links to the Waltzing Matilda, and I'll show you now all of the jokes about that. They're all built into the massive mansions that these people still have all over the world. Okay, so we won't need the Rothschild archive again. I'm going to leave that up because I need to archive that one. Yeah, and I failed to mention that the launch of the Austro-Hungarian factor involves Franz Joseph. Yeah, Joseph with the coat of many colours becomes Ben Yusuf for Islam and the Moors. Yeah, and many of the things that they build have Moorish structures. Yeah, just to get that haunting impression that there's someone out there who's going to harm us because they worship another god to us. Yet the gods in the heavens are all the same people, and they've been looking down on this whole story with horror since time began. Okay, so you can look that up for yourself. It's really interesting. And there is Baroness, she's a beautiful, beautiful woman, and she's got a body double in Kelso, and I saw her in the pub last night. Yeah, and that's Baroness Philippe de Rothschild, the former Pauline Potter at Chateau Mouton, 1961. That's the famous champagne outlet in France. Okay, and there's one with a, that's Baron Maurice de Rothschild with Dolores del Rio at Santa Barbara, California, and he's got bigger tits than Colin Montgomery. Yeah, these are the books that I was able to find before the Harris family from Butlins were able to buy all of the Borders books on the Rothschild family. Yeah, they scurried around all over the Borders purchasing the books when I was working for them on the Henderside beat. Yeah, and that is in the Duke of Northumberland's Poison Castle region. It's Barter Books, and it is a fascinating place. Yeah, they've got a links to electronic search engines, and you can find almost all of the world's deepest secrets from there, and they are complicit as through my lobbying in all of the things that I've reported. Yeah, none of them ever replied, but because I'm their customer and because I got my their email address, they get all of the crimes and the war crimes of Iraq, and all of it is led by this lot. Yeah, and the profits are laundered by this lot. Okay, and the Concord project is explained in the family motto, Concordia Industria and Integrity, Hannah Rothschild. Yeah, the whole of your shallow life, you're the most innocent of the lot, which is why I'm trying to reach out to you. Yeah, that's the Rothschilds archived website. Yeah, and the Potters of the Nerve Gases, and that was launched in Syria, and today in the Catholic Church we have a man telling us that Christianity is being persecuted in the Holy Lands. Yeah, he cites the Armageddon region, he cites all of the places where Tony Blair brutalised the people. I don't remember what the place names were now, but every one of the citations he gave was part of Blair's genocide in that region. That's the Christian world led by the English speaking people that brutalise every fucking where. Right then, so the Rumpelstiltskin story is typically opportunist. There it is, I will not play it for you in case I get copyrighted. Okay? And the pictures that we've got of the woman with the scantily clad gear on. Sorry, it was just captured at the beginning of the video the last time. So, the little blue dress for Eva Braun is in all the stories. Yeah, it's in Elton John's Dangerous Game, when the angel comes to visit. It's in the Pinocchio stories, and all of it is the same repeating joke. Okay, and that is Eva Braun's Escape from the Bunker. Van Rompuy is a cover for the Profiteering. So this story is that the dwarf comes down, he allows the woman to spin the gold, which gets her married to the king. Yeah, and then they need to find out the name of the man. Yeah, that's why Rompuy is the head of the EU scam. His boss Barroso had to resign. Yeah, and all of it, the massive banking scams, are all Rothschild runs. Okay, let me show you some more pictures. Okay, and it's a massive, yeah. So all of the place names that I'm going to tell you take you into these characters. Yeah, this is Fred Christ Trump, the dad of that one, the Aryan blonde. Yeah, and there's the Skull and Bones pictures, all the American warmongering, all the roof scene negotiations for the Devil's Advocate. Yeah, this is the people that are related to Hillary Clinton from Normandy. Yeah, they're actually from Germany and they're further across the world. And all of the jokes are in the architects of the Rothschilds' houses or the people that lived in the Rothschild houses. Yeah, remember that they emanated from Germany too. Let's quickly take you back in case we miss anything. Although it might spoil the rest of the story, we'll leave it there just in case I need it. Okay? So, there is the woman that becomes the princess. because she uses that to weave gold, and that is what the Rothschilds have done. They've taken the capacity to make all of the world's gold coins, all of the world's banknotes, all of the world's electronic money is now in their hands, and the capacity to issue it only to their elite friends. That's Von Rompuy with the 12. Sorry, that is an error. Yeah, the pun is absolutely intended. That is Von Rompuy. Yeah? Pie, pie, yeah? Pew, pew, Barney McGrew, in all the jokes that they have. Right then. And the Göttingen professors that invented it make the no-god joke. Yeah? It's absolutely ruthless, and you can see the straw at her feet, and that becomes the straw man in the jokes about Alice in Wonderland and the golden brick road to Berlin. Yeah, Berlin's not in the middle of Germany, it's way out in the far east of Germany, which is the split that is the joke about the actual democracy and the fighting of the communists. I explained to you yesterday how the Austrian anthem and its icons has the sickle and the hammer for the communism, so that all of the divide and kill 'em when they come home after fighting for their country. And these sad bastards, yeah, they got the peace prize soon after he took over. Right then, so let's go to the archive and shame the Rothschilds for real, because this is their output. Okay, and there's the stories about Princess Charlotte's death. So Prince Leopold was the uncle of Queen Victoria and the uncle of the Germans back in Hanover. Yeah, and sadly his missus died in childbirth, and that is the story I told you about milestones in midwifery. Yeah, one of the medics who get the blame for that. That's God's work. Yeah, God determines whether the good people can have babies and whether the evil people that steal from their country and kill as mass murderers, yeah, can allow their babies to thrive, yeah, and inherit their estates. Michael Ancram was at the church today. He's limping a bit, he's looking really sheepish. Yeah, but I got there so late that I did not dare walk out early, because I thought that would be obtrusive. And then the fundraisers came pleading for justice in Iraq, all over the crime scene that I reported in yesterday's video, which is one of the most important I've ever made. That is the cover-up by the Christian profiteers. Yeah, he's on a fundraiser. It's his second visit to our parish since 2011. They're creating seminaries in the Middle East. There are no fucking seminaries left in Britain. Yeah, they have to go to Spain now to get trained as Catholic priests. And that's part of the globalism fraud and the interlocks to the Lloyds Banking Group that mean that all of the people that in the El Cid movies are still leaders of men, but they're in the Lloyds Banking Group. That's Ortario. Yeah, it's totally pathetic. Yeah, and there's Leopold, Victoria's mother, and Albert's father. Yeah, and all of it is intertwined, but they are not the real parents of Victoria's children. You now know that. Michael Ancram knows it too. They're really ashamed of it now. Yeah, and there is the biggest shock of the lot. Okay, this is where the Rothschilds lived, in Italy. Yeah, that's in the Rothschild archive. This has already been featured in many of my videos, but it does not tell you anywhere other than in the Rothschild website that they ran the mint in the Via Chihaha, Naples, Italy, where the whole Bible was defrauded. Yeah, by the Piso family. Okay? And it's got the reverence to the Pisos with the name Pignatelli. Pignatelli is the boss at Strathclyde University. I've met the fat bastard. Yeah, and the Villa stuff. Aston Villa are in the relegation zone. Leicester are up there because Gary Lineker is in divorce proceedings because all of the things that I have reported. So this is the mint in fucking Naples for the Italian nation. Yeah? And it was run, the villa had been built for an English minister, Sir Ferdinand Acton. So that's all the cover-ups of Ferdinand and Isabel for the killing in the Inquisition of all of those millions and millions of Catholics, pagans, Protestants. Yeah, all over Europe. Yeah, led by the Hispanic people. Yeah, that get totally displaced eventually by the English people. And that's Manuel in the Basil Fawlty joke that I explained to you yesterday. Okay, full view of the river Kaya. Yeah, that's the Kai name in the naming of Cairo in Egypt. Yeah, all of it is in the Pizzo code. Surrounded by beautiful countryside, it was neoclassical in style, and Karl Kalman, the first man to visit the Pope, who was allowed to kiss the ring on his finger rather than to fall at his feet, as the Pizzos wrote for the Jesus fraud. Yeah, added two floors to house staff and officials. Here he and his wife, Adelaide, yeah, all the Adele jokes, entertained distinguished guests, including Queen Victoria's favourite uncle, Leopold of Saxe-Coburg. That's the one whose wife lost the baby. Living it up in Isha. Yeah, and I've learned now that the creators of Kelso's church include a Chalmers. And Craig Chalmers from the Melrose Freemasons went away. He's in the Grand Slam winning team for Scotland. Yeah, he's in that Scottish Freedom joke run by the Masons so that they can keep their friends in the lodge and get drinks from them. Yeah, he was an excellent rugby player. He was an excellent and committed amateur coach. Yeah, but because I was on his correspondence list, yeah, he was forced out of the region, and he now coaches Isha, which was Queen Victoria's favourite place because the Rothschilds could not rape her there. Yeah, and that's the Brett of Isha, and it is the round table for Cecil Rhodes. Yeah, it's absolutely massive. Okay, it's now a museum, the Museo Principe Diego of Aragon, Pignatelli Cortez, that brutalised the Andes. Yeah, with the Christian stuff, and that is the massive joke that is the mission film. Yeah, with all of the massive decisions that the papal representatives have to make about what happens to the people in the jungle, and all of them eventually die. And those are the places where the first civilizations were, like the Holy Lands that they're raising funds for at the Catholic Church this morning. Totally unashamed, totally to cover my declarations yesterday that World War One was started by the Rothschild family, yeah, because they are running the central bank in Austria, and the man who's the contender for the power base in Austria is Franz Joseph. Yeah, the Joseph name is the same joke as Joseph in Nazareth, yeah, and Ben Yusuf in Islam and the Moors. Yeah, and some of the Rothschilds' mansions have a Moorish look. Yeah, just to keep that divide and conquer thing going. Okay, and the woman's name in the story about what we just looked at, the Rumpelstiltskin story, yeah, the woman's name is Anna, and the offshoot from Naples, when the Pizzos and all of them left there, yeah, that's Emperor Constantine headed for Constantinople, and all the frauds there, her name was Anna in the fairy tale, and the Anna Ainichi are the people that take religion east and west, eventually into Ireland. And some of the jokes about Ireland and the murders there and all the wars are absolutely ruthless. Yeah, that's the Gallipoli song, and the Kai, it's part of the place names for the Rothschilds. Okay, so there's Clermont. Okay, and we've not yet got to the Rothschilds thing. I believe that the list of places that they have, okay, there's, yeah, the list of places that they have, there's a place called, it's a dead ringer for Otterburn. I've just told you about the Ottoman Empire and Otto Piso being part of that. But yesterday I spotted somewhere, just as I was closing, that there is an Otterburn Rothschild residence. But I don't see it there. Might be in Holland. Castle de Haar. And there's the massive Ibs places, Gosling, and the goose jokes where the Archduke's son was murdered. Yeah? In the affair there, all the bloody affairs. Yeah? And then the Archduke himself was murdered on the Hume Bridge in Sarajevo. Where is that link to Otterburn? Yeah? And I noticed that the man in the movies about the massive double agency issues in, where is it, Rue de Florence. So there's many more in France, because the French are really deceitful and really good at lying, and they are the other second biggest hub to the Scottish Freemasons. Yeah, and we get all their useless coaches and all their political advice and all the allies through the Bonnie Prince Charlie thing. Is just a more efficient way of killing the Scottish soldiers. Yeah, but I can't see what I saw yesterday on the name of that Otterburn mansion for the Rothschilds. So Windmill Hill, Wadsden, Tring Park, The Pleasance, Swinton Grange. Yeah, my loyalist allies that pretended that they were going to bust things open and make videos with me. Robbie Swinton. Yeah. Yeah, he's bailed out totally now. He doesn't want me to be his Facebook friend. Yeah. Rushbrook Hall, Palace House, New Court, Mentmore Towers, Inchmerry House, Halton, Gunnersbury, Flint House, the Flintstones launch, Aston, Bill Clinton, yeah, the Queen's half-brother, yeah, and the Queen is related directly to the Rothschilds through the King of Kings and his nephew, who did all of the shagging of Queen Victoria. Arundel House, yeah, that's Arundel, that we've talked about a lot in the context of Michael Ancram's wife. The Mosleys, the fascists of Reedsdale. Yeah, it is totally twisted. Yeah, there's Hamilton Place. Yeah, and this is the Rothschilds' residences. Kensington Palace Gardens. Piccadilly. Yeah, where I had to go to the mezzanine building to get permission from the royals still in Britain to go as a worker to New Zealand. And that is the beautiful song that Hayley Westenruth sings. Brings tears to my eyes, because I've come away from New Zealand without fixing things for them. I'm doing my best to do it now, and some of them still appreciate that. Many of them communicate with me, particularly when they get their cancers. It's totally twisted. Yet the whole world is treasonous. Still belongs to the families that were running the wars way back in the Napoleonic times. Okay? And so Great St Helens, yeah, it's tragic. That's rugby league country, yeah, and all of it. That's the Kensington KP joke for the Freemasons. The Duke of Kent, the Royal, was the leading Freemason after all of the shenanigans of the Jack the Ripper murders, Hamilton Place. Okay, as I take you down the tabs, you'll see the Hesses of Hamilton and all of the jokes about it. Okay, so that's a lot of time on that, and I still cannot see what I saw at the end of yesterday's video on the Otterburn scam. Yet, do you get the Otto Piso thing and the launch of the Ottoman Empire and the Half Moon and Tommy Cooper's premature death, because he's a Mason that makes a joke about all of the warmongering through that massive region? Okay, here's the Claremont House, which we've seen before. Yeah, that explains the death of Clive of India and all of the jokes of Cecil Rhodes in Round Table and the Arthurian jokes. The Arthurian stories were written by the popes in Rome. Yeah, it's a mutual agreement to steal the whole world from its people and its innocent worshippers. Many of the Catholics will not know any of this story. I don't know whether or not the priests know it. Right then. Yeah, and it's just a little bit away from the stammering Windsor Castle. And one of the Weatherstones deserted me yesterday. They're telling me that they fear for my future because they've tried to bang me up already. That's the local councillors. I bought him a pint. He never appeared again to buy me one back. Yeah. The Freemasons are totally pathetic. They steal from themselves without even the vaguest insight. Right then. Yeah, and the beneficiaries are the Dukes of Kent. They do not stay in front of the cameras for any length of time now. So we've seen that one. That takes us all through Queen Victoria's really, really sad love life. It takes us through the murder of Prince Albert and all of the siring of all of her children by the Rothschilds, right next to Michael Ancram's holdings, yeah, opposite the Isle of Wight in Southampton and up those river valleys that are owned by the barons of Teviotdale. Right, quickly, let's get to the Swiss Pregni stuff. Okay, and some more images. Built like Aston Clinton and meant for the shores of Lake Geneva, just like the Von Trapp, beautiful movie about World War II and the homeland issues for Austria. Yeah, it's already Rothschild's Austria, it's already Hitler Rothschild's Alpine region, Austria. Yeah, and the Austria naming is the Aryan master race, like Australia. Yeah, and it's by Lake Geneva. Yeah, and all of the stuff and the banking frauds in Switzerland are theirs. Adolf Karl de Rothschild, 1823 to 1900, bought it in 1857. Okay, massive, ugly looking pile. All the round windows and the square windows from the children's programmes on BBC Light Entertainment, launched by Eric Maswich. Okay, Park and Gardens, Chateau de Pregny, Switzerland. Yeah, nothing very sensational, but it was built by the Paxtons. Yeah, that's Professor Paxton's family in Auckland. Yet none of them will talk to me now. Yeah, that's all of the people that had me bounced out of New Zealand for being an outspoken person and explaining all of the Japanese nerve gas attacks, even the toxicology of the head lice, which is the Archie Louse Piso jokes. Yeah, all of them are on the take in their new continents. Yeah, and all of them run those shrubberies that the pythons laugh at. And the Hayley Westenra's songs are absolutely brilliant, but and they also reflect her being on both sides now. She came and entertained George W. Bush in the White House. Yeah, on her global odyssey, as I was taking mine in New Zealand. Yeah, and exposing all of the nerve gases, all of the toxicology, all of the obesity epidemics and retailing scams, and all of the asset stripping of all of the great professions and putting people into the Royal Society, yeah, as the leading Freemasons. That's Frank Griffin from Ireland, who laughs at the Irish troubles, like all of the profiteers do, because it's part of the art, like Islam. Okay, and the Ferrier's stories, and they're massive, and on that family tree they're all through the story. Yeah, so that's the Irish. There are many more Irish ones than any French ones than anything else. Yeah, I want to get to that Untertag because it is lethal. Yeah, and the gas, do you get the gas chambers joke now in the showers in the Schindler's List movie? Do you get it that Helen Hirsch, who's picked to be raped and pillaged by the ruthless man that is Goethe, Helen Hirsch is a Rothschild, like Mrs. Potter. Yeah, and the nerve gas creators at Rothamsted, now only funded to work on Bill Clinton's global warming scam, and the Paris centres for that are the eco-banks that pretend that God is not in charge of our universe now, and the humans are responsible for polluting it en masse. The nerve gases never get a mention. Yeah, that's Rothamsted's only funding stream now, is to study the non-existent global warming which is attributed to humans. Yeah, everything that God does is totally dictates how the world is run, with volcanic eruptions, with earthquakes, with landslides, with massive biblical floods, or the volcanic action that occurred in Naples in 79 AD when they released the New Testament, and when they were guessing the name of the dwarf in the story that we just heard, the first guesses were Matthew, Mark, Luke or John. Isn't that funny for the people, the Rothschilds, who have Jesus's holy relics in Wadsden, in fucking Hertfordshire, right next to the place where the nerve gases were invented. And I've got pictures of that, and let me now go to the, so this is their financial centres in Frankfurt. All of them had to be destroyed by Bomber Harris in World War II. That's the Harrises of Hertfordshire and the Butlins people. Nay, with a donkey on the beach. That's Nay, Mrs. Valerie Jane Lees. Nay Hancock's asset stripping the dentistry. 70 grand, 90 grand for dental students for the honours degree that your brother got for free. And he got his OBE from the Queen for doing all of that stealing from the kids. And that's the Windsor Queen, who's actually a Saxe Coburg, and a genocidal person for ages and ages and ages, and she makes the pacifist speaks every Xmas. Right then. And Fargas. So do you get it? The gas and the shaving of the heads in the Christian Bible. Put them in the fire pans. And those that are work and fight for the one true God in our massive conflicts, you can have 32,000 virgins for that, all of it still in the Bible. And this is the Vienna stuff. So do you get it? The Pignatelli is now the boss at Strathclyde University. That's the Piso Pie Pie Life of Pie jokes, all of the American Pie jokes that I've explained in every video. Right then, let's show you this one. It's got pictures in it. Might be able to keep your attention. Okay, it's absolutely so I'm now beginning to look at the German places of residence of the Rothschilds. And all of the war criminality is used by them as a cover up for the names of their home. Okay, so this is Unter Main Kai in Frankfurt. The Kai is in the story about the lead up to the Gallipoli conflict. Listen to the Pogue songs about Gallipoli and hear them sailing past the Kai. The Main is the name of the river. Am Main. And Untermeyer is the man that was planted into the central court in America the Supreme Court in America to demonise German goods and to extend World War One from 1917 right up to the end of 1918. Yeah, that's 11/11, Armistice Day, right at the end of the year. Yeah, and that is the profiteering efforts of the Queen, Butcher Haig, and all of the ceramic puppies at the war memorial every year. Yeah, and the appearances of those bosses, and Tom Hanks Rockefeller is on the front page of the Scottish papers today, thanks to yesterday's video about the starting of World War One and the Normandy beachhead where Hillary Clinton and her bloodline came from. Yeah, that's the Channel Islands right next door, and the Barclay brothers, yeah, the barley, and turning it all to gold in the banking dynasties. Yeah, which the Rothschilds are legendary for. Okay, so there it is. It's got a Moorish look. Yeah, all of them look like, when you look at the final scenes in The Devil's Advocate and you look at the pictures of the Rothschilds' mansions, it's just like looking at the devil dancing with his son and his naked daughter, Connie Nielsen, from the tribes of Denmark. Okay? There it is. So, and let me show you what comes into their story. So there is, the designers of it are, and the architects are named, and they are, okay, Hess and Speer are the designers. Yeah, do you get that? That's Hess of Hamilton, Hitler, Rothschild's second in command, are the architects who built, and the Albert Speer character, the pictures are further down, and that's British trained Hitler Rothschild regime. Frederick Rumpf is also in the story about this house. Yeah, that's the Trumps, and their middle name is Christ. Yeah, and that is Hillary Clinton's cousin from Normandy, and they're further east. So they are in the German lineages. Okay, the Kai is the Kaiser, and the Narrows south of Gallipoli. When then the Dukes of Cambridge were sat on the deck chairs when the genocides at Gallipoli occurred. Yeah, that's the current Duke of Cambridge is, I think, Prince William. Yeah, Kate's all over the papers again, and she's looking quite ragged now. Yeah, all the bones are sticking out in her jaws, and it's really dangerous thing to steal from the whole world and pretend that you're a legitimate princess who went, her mum went to Thames Poly with me. Okay, and there's the dear old Claremont thing for Queen Victoria, the poor shag bag for the Rothschilds. Okay, the next one is the Bockenheimer, that's the killing of Dieter Bock in popular culture, and the company that my wife used to work for out of Germany. Yeah, Dieter Bock was killed by the fascists that are in the Devil's River. I forget the name of the river that runs out of that region. Yeah, but my wife got totally blind drunk there when we went to a party, and everything that God does is a message. Yeah, it's absolutely amazing. And I did not know about the suicide of Clive of India until last week. Okay, Frankfurt's master builder Johann C.F. Hess is a luxurious for the funding from banker Joseph Isaac Speer. Yeah, Britney Spears, the whole shooting match is covered up with tier after tier. Karl von Rothschild bought the property in 1846, and he got architect Friedrich Rumpf to make the alterations. Isn't that great? Yeah, and all of them become war criminals, and all of them get executed, and the Rothschilds do not even appear on the Forbes rich list. And it has that Moorish, kind of Turkish look about it, like a seraglio in the Mozart film. Yeah, and what happened to Mozart, yeah, who was a Freemason too, was that he got his musical dances, the music was shut down, like my video soundtracks on everything that Bill Clinton has done. This is Albert Speer, not the people who built the home. Yeah, this is the Nazi war criminals. Yeah, and the people that lead you to believe that everything you believe is a lie. That's the greatest ambitions of the Nazi leadership team. That is Hitler, Rothschild, and the swastika for the global Freemasons. Bob Hogarth and all the people I was drinking with yesterday, and eventually they scammed me out of my pint. Okay, so Untermannkai, Frankfurt, Germany. Do you see the link to Untermeyer? Yeah, just three letters on the end. Yeah, and there is banker Joseph Isaac Speer. The design was unusual, and there's Friedrich Rumpf. When you look for the Trumps, there's my search for his dad. Yeah, Fred Christ Rumpf is that man. Yeah, Christ is his middle name. Out of the German bloodlines, all of them have Christ as the middle name. Yeah, that's sectarian Germany. That is the Holy Roman Emperors. Yeah, and all of them are in the bloodlines, right up to FDR and the Bushes. It's a really lovely, lovely, warm-hearted story, isn't it? And there's Untermeyer and Brandeis in the extension with the Balfour Declarations and all the blackmails, yeah, of the American presidents after World War II. But this one's about extending the war. Yeah. And the Blackadder people, yeah, pretend that that is done by a cunning man at Oxford University. Yeah, it's done by the Americans, yeah, and all the propaganda there. And the Dreyfus case gets all the French people riled up, and all of them get killed. And they've got dozens and dozens of insurgents and free French people, yeah, like the free Polish, and all of them are led by leaders who spend their war on in other countries. That's the Belgian and French escapees, and they're in Buckinghamshire, Hertfordshire and Bedfordshire with the Rothschilds and the Cheneys. And there is my story about the Fleming family, and the Fleming family linked to Michael Ancrum, yeah, through all. And I found Bruce Scott, my family friends. Yeah, all of the people that visited us in New Zealand and are friends of my wife still. That's the traitors to me. Yeah, who used to be, and they came to my housewarming when we had my party here. It's the Cassies that are linked in to the Cassies of the Rothschild family in Europe when they were working for the emperors and the heads of the Austrian nation. Yeah, suddenly they become the bosses when they murder two generations of them. Yeah, and that's the Archduke that is the legendary launch of World War One. Okay, so do you get it? Yeah, and that is the first boss at the Bank of England. Give me the ownership of the issuance of money and I will tell you who leads that country. Yeah, they've led it ever since. Yeah, and there is Rudolf Hess. His relative that appears as the obfuscation tool is Jimmy Carr on the telly. And I used to live right next door to the Carrs in the Inch region in Kelso. Yeah. Yeah, and it's amazing. And they still worship at the... they don't worship at the Catholic Church. But they had terrible pathologies in the family, and I still remember the screaming through the walls at night. Yeah, God gives you what you deserve in the end. But since they started the toxicology research and the nerve gas research, then they become even more powerful as the master race, and you can even impose dementia on people. Yeah, using the prions that were the focus of all of the lab research. And the number of people who got dementia in the Far East when the Japanese were invading the islands, yeah, I'm a specialist in that area too. Those toxins can give lab animals dementia, and you can give human beings dementia. Yeah, like Muhammad Ali, when he becomes a bit outspoken and he's prepared to release all the information, but he will not go and fight in Vietnam like all of the other suckers. Yeah, and Muhammad Ali is just part of, if you've not noticed it already, the Lord Liverpool frauds out of India. Muhammad Ali is a friend of Lord McCartney of Liverpool, where Hitler was trained. Right then, so, and there's a little bit more of the story. Okay, the house took on a slightly different character with Moorish and Middle Eastern features. Yeah, this is fucking Frankfurt, notably the arabesque balustrades, which perhaps took their inspiration from the new summer palace in Stuttgart of King William of Württemberg, built in 1842. In 1894, Hannah Louisa, Karl's granddaughter, established the Baron Karl von Rothschild Public Library in the house in memory of her father. The woman in the Rumpelstiltskin story is called Hannah. Or, no, sorry, she's called Anna. Okay, and Hannah, have you noticed it, reads the same back to front. Yeah, and plump Hannah, married to the British Prime Minister, is further down the tabs. Okay, this one is Bocken. So Dieter Bock was murdered. Yeah, and that is part of the story about the companies that my wife worked for. Yeah, and he was murdered by his rivals in Germany. Okay, 8 to 10 Bockenmeyer Strasse, Frankfurt. All of these get burnt to the ground and bombed by Bomber Harris, the Rothschild's neighbour in Hertfordshire. Yeah, isn't it funny? And absolutely lethal for all of the ordinary troops who have to wear... Let me take you through the pictures. Yeah, because I'm wandering a bit. There's not really anything as sensational as Sarajevo in this one. But there's Fred Christ Trump. Let's go back. And there is the Brandeis. Oh, we've done that. But we've got the nerve gases in the middle. There is Albert Speer. Okay. There is Rudolf Hess. We could look for Jimmy Carr. There is the nerve gases. I had in the family attic a gas mask that I used to play with as a child on the Balfour farm. Yeah, all of my hobby horses have been taken away, and Prince George is now this picture this weekend riding his hobby piezo horse. Yeah, there are all sides sharing the technology. Yeah, and all of the Rothamsted discoveries and all of the research into how to counter it was shared with the other side. In World War One, the Krupps in Germany are the massive munitions manufacturers. Yeah, and they are the owners now of the massive hotel chains that link into the Colditz of Kelso Brookses. Yeah, that's the Colditz family that went to Colditz and were the Brookses that run Edenham House Hotel. Yeah, and they pretend that that was taken over by the Church of Scotland, but it's actually in receivership. They've walked away with the cash while the going is good. Typical of all of the pump and dump and economic crashes in the lead up to war. Yeah, and that is the major cause of death in Gallipoli is dysentery. Yeah, and the Turks are on top of the hill. They know it's all going to happen because they're all in the same profiteering teams. Yeah, and the Germans are on board the British ships as the Dukes of Cambridge. Yeah, and the people that erected Windsor Palace for the Saxe Coburgs, watching it on the deck chairs. And New Zealand has succumbed. That, I believe, is Charles Potter. First met him, and his bench fell over. The end opposite which he sat on went right up in the air. Yeah, and That is Rothamsted Research Station, where now the only thing they're looking into is global warming, which is a massive act of God. Yeah, and all of the things that are happening, yeah, all of the nitrogen fixation that we used to get, and all of the creation of oxygen in the massive rainforests, they have been flattened by McDonald's. Yeah, and that's McDonald Detweiler, who make the drones to kill the people on different continents without even declaring war. And in the wedding sector now, you can get your wedding photos taken by drone from up above. And if you don't like your husband, I suppose that's a good way to take him out on day one. Yeah, it's really, really efficient. You should think about that, Mrs. Valerie Jane Lees, for your next husband, if you've got a troublesome one who's prepared to release the truth. Right then, so Rothamsted, and my people are friendly there. They've explained to me how all of their funding for toxicology and making treatments in agriculture safe has now been disappeared, and the global warming scam is the beneficiary of all of that. All of the expertise that we had is now being shafted like that. And the man who's really loyal to me is called Martin Williamson, and he's a great guy. Yeah, openly communicates. He's looking for friends that can understand the nervous system and how we can protect humans from the terrible damage that is done by the things that I told you about, as the avermectins and the toxicology of the offshore salmon farms that are openly taken on in Scotland by the traitor that is Alex Salomon Rothschild. Dr. Potter is an expert on the nerve gases like sarin and tabin. Yeah, and further down the picture you'll see images of them. I think that was on the last one though. Yeah, and there's the, oh sorry, we're going the wrong way. Nerve gases. So there's all the Syrian scandals. Yeah, and the people in Syria are now hosting the Catholic seminaries. That's what they tell you. There will be no Catholic seminaries. It's just another collection in the Catholic fraud, so that the Rothschilds, who are the owners of the Catholic Church, since Kalman Rothschild visited it, out of the fucking Via Pignatelli. There's the chemistry of the nerve gases, and everything that happened in the Japanese subways, in all of the cover-ups. Yeah, when I was fighting only against Lord Sainsbury and the science ministry stuff that mean that we have a global obesity epidemic now. Okay, Great British nerve agent. Yeah, and they're absolutely lethal. Yeah, and you need to be on an iron lung like Dr. Shazel was if you're prepared to work on things like that, and you're a traitor to the world's people like Dr. Shazel, who is a traitor to the students in his own institution of Durham. All of the officials have had to resign from that university since I became an honorary professor, and they've not had the courage to take me down, because that will look like a vicious kickback for someone who's trying to save all of their students in that £70,000 debt burden. Yeah, and there's de Gaulle, who safely went to Berkhamsted, and all of my stories about that man, Hitler Rothschild, and the goose stepping that is linked to the villa and the sporting shooting lodge where the son of the Archduke was killed to launch World War I and to dispossess the Archduke's family of the whole of Austria. Yeah? Since the Mayor Rothschild took over. And that's why it's the Mayerling incident. Right. Yeah, and that is Assad, the Queen's friend in Syria. Yeah, that is me losing my job the day I was trying to negotiate the peace for that country. Yeah, and it was the Selkirk Freemasons. And that's Bill Drew, and the Druze are a massive power base, yeah, in continental Europe. Okay? And it is totally twisted. And all the kilties don't understand it. they were drinking in the pub last night, and all of it is absolutely ruthless. They die in Tyrol, which is the Austrian homeland for the Bavarians, and the man who's in the Normandy Beach film and on the front page of the Scottish papers today. No Michael Ancram on the front page of the Scottish papers. Okay, and there's the little red joke about bringing the colours in when they win in the end. Yeah, she likes gas. She likes to kill people en masse. And there you've got the Olympian joke. Yeah, that the gods in Olympia in Greece have now been totally replaced by Jesus, with the same initials as Julius Caesar. Okay, and there's the nerve gases in the laboratory and all of the demonization of the fact that these people now have them. That is our government officials and our intel agents with a balaclava on. And that was a massive genocide of British troops, yeah, in the Crimean War. Right, so let's get a little bit further down the tab and show you some of the mundane stories about all of the Rothschilds' properties all over the world. Okay, so there's the Bochum Strasse in Frankfurt. They've got loads there, but there are none there now. Or they're all decrepit wrecks, like the seminaries in Glasgow that I've told you the stories about. And the seminary in the Borders is right next to David Murray's Nene Donkey Field for Jesus. Yeah, that's where the seminary was, right next to the Borders Council, who tried to section me and scam me out of the beer yesterday. Okay, Guntersburg Palace, Bornheim, Frankfurt. Okay, it's got a fucking orangery in it. Yeah, sectarian orangery. And this is where his mother, Uncle Charles Rothschild, is the most magnificent house, and it's Lionel that owns it. His mother, plump Mrs. Rosebery of Lochleven in Scotland and Naples, that's Hannah Rothschild, married to Archie Rosebery, the Prime Minister in Britain, in the lead up to the wars in Khartoum, I think. Yeah, I have no doubt of its being a magnificent residence, but at present the grounds and garden do not accord with English tastes. Yeah. So that's plump Hannah, who died with a horrible blood cancer, aged 40. Okay, and do not dissimilar to the Villa Medici, that's the other money-lending family, before the people in Bavaria, the two rival branches of that, and their names are on the next tab for Bavaria. Let me just give you them now so you can get them ringing in your head. So the Bavarians are the Fuggers, yeah, you fucker, yeah, do you get it? Yeah, with the GG for the Pisos right in the middle, and the Queen Mum. Okay, there's the Bowie, the Boy tribes of Alpine region. There's the Bears and the Lynx to Longshanks, yeah, and all of the 100 land division scams all across England. Yeah, and the Augsburg region is where the Welsers live as neighbours to the Fuggers. Yeah, that becomes the Rothschilds in the course of time after they were called the Bears. And there's the links to it. Do you get it? Yeah, 600 to 800 AD, when Christianity is still being launched by these sad, deviant bastards, and it's still the supreme, biggest cause of death in the whole world, in the whole of world history. Yeah, and they're pretending now that the Christians are persecuted. They're persecuted only by me. The rest of them are too sheepish to do anything about it. Right, so, sorry, we've gotten off Rothschild Global. Yeah, it's absolute, and that's the Welshies, all my friends, and all of it is ancient history. They need not be ashamed of it. Okay, but the English thing is ever so treasonous.
Yeah.
Scotland can never be free when we have Alex Salamond Rothschild and the woman who is totally committed to dismembering our country.
Yeah.
She's Sturgeon. Yeah. Also the Germanic links to Frankfurt and all of these places. Okay? So the Medicis were the money lenders before the Rothschilds killed them all. Okay? And the orangery in Frankfurt can no longer be found. Yeah, that's the orangery that they had in Versailles. And all of the links of the Brookses to Kelso to Versailles. They told me that themselves. Yeah, it's absolutely massive. And there is the orangery in Guntersberg Palace. So this one still exists. Okay, beautiful, beautiful building. The big house, somehow or other, got flattened in the war. But the orangery is okay, like all of the places in Hertfordshire, Bedfordshire, Buckinghamshire, and central London that were immune from bombing. Because the Windsors live there. Yeah, it's at, and Göttingen and Heidelberg were also immune from bombing, because those are the power base universities where the Grimms come from, and they are the source of almost all of the German chancellors through all of the democracy in inverted commas. Yeah, and that is Schroeder and the Schroeder banks. Gerhard Schroeder was the man who scammed the power station that was blown up at, I forget where it was, up on the Baltic coast. Yeah, and that then leads to the closure of all of the nuclear power stations all over the world, and everybody living in negative equity in terms of energy production. That's Schroeder's bank that funded that Mrs. David Cameron in the coercing of all of the 9/11 people to take us into the war in Iraq, yeah, which they're still abusing, yeah, as Christians. Yeah, and they claim to have seminaries there and to be producing thousands of brothers per year. There is no seminary in Britain now. It's all a lie. Okay, so next one is the Green Shield. Not sure what that is. There it is. And this is the little pump that we had. It's a luxurious thing in the old days. The house at the Green Shield contained a water pump, considered to be a great luxury at the time. On my farm, where I had the hobby horse, yeah, now been stolen by the Church of Scotland profiteer that is my Auntie Anne, yeah, married to a Gilbert from Hamilton. Yeah, and he's a profiteer all over sub-Saharan Africa for all of his life, and he got sacked and pillaged by Deirdre Hutton at the Borders NHS. Much more modern than the one we had at Harriet's Field on the Balfour's farm. With the help of sons Salomon and Amshel, the family became a major wholesaler of wool, cotton and flour, and in mid-1790s Rothschild became a major importer of cotton cloth from England. In 1796, Napoleon's troops attacked Frankfurt, accidentally setting the JudenGasse on fire. Yeah, that's Napoleon, who was a relative of Louis XIV, and destroying half of it, leaving 2,000 inhabitants homeless. The displaced Jews were allowed to live in the Christian part of the city for 6 months, and Napoleon's elite places of exile, yeah, are still tax havens and elite places for holidays. Yeah, and his name, his body double that was left on Elba, I forget what his name was, but the real one came back, and there were so many body doubles that he decided to pack up in Paris. It's absolutely, and then Napoleon III becomes the ruthless joke. So this is the JudenGasse, and they were required to live apart from the Christians in a narrow lane called Jews Alley. Yeah, there's the houses that they have there. and the house of the red shield. So this is the black door and the green door jokes. Yeah? And I've explained those to you already. And Mayor Amschel Rothschild, the son of Amschel Moses Rothschild and Schoen Rothschild, was born in Frankfurt, the fourth of eight children. His father was a money changer and a dealer in silk. That is still all of the Krasnosy Elk jokes that was the launch point for World War II, right next door to Treblinka. Yeah, and every time I'm gonna make these stories, the people with the names from my family friends come forward and sheepishly appear in the supermarket. Yeah? It's absolutely tragic that they feel afflicted by what happened all those years ago. Yeah? So, it's a common practice to give names to houses such as White Tulip, Ship, Green Jar, etc. And this is the Elkanan story. So Elkanan Rothschild, yeah, Isaac Elkanan is the Rothschild icon that means that we have all of the jokes about Braveheart and stabbing people with elk horns. Yeah, and the elk shoots in Norway are legendary, and all the scary stories that I was told by my mate who had a heart attack as soon as he deserted me in New Zealand. His name is Andrew Rice. And that is the Icknield Way joke, yeah? And I went fishing with him, yeah? And I had to give up a fishing trip on the Test and the Itchen, where Michael Ancrum lives with Lord Mountbatten and all of those. That is the barons of Teviotdale, when the Germans were thrown out of the Teviot Valley and had to change their location to fascist Hampshire. Okay? And so do you get it? The elk horns on every image in every popular culture film is a cover for the Rothschilds and the corrupted political world and the Clintons and the Trumps and all of the candidates in the American election and all of the current leaders of Britain. Yeah? Cameron is Camerinus in the Roman court. House of the Green Shield, the JudenGasse, Frankfurt. Let's keep going. Next one is Waltzing Matilda. Let's just see if there are any sensational pictures. Oh, there's a lot of highlighted stuff. Oh, here's the Kalman. Mayor Rothschild returned home to Frankfurt. There he joined his brother Kalman's money-changing business. That's Kalman, the first one to start taking on the asset stripping of the Vatican. His first visit there allowed him to kiss the hand of the Pope, not his feet. Okay? So, adding his own speciality to his trade in rare coins, medals, curios, jewels, engravings, and antiques. Through this business, Rothschild was introduced to Crown Prince Wilhelm and the future Landgrave, Prince of Hess. Do you get it? That's Rudolf Hess, the architect of the Rothschild homes, and the massive links to Hanover, yeah, that is the Hesses of Hamilton and Rudolf Hess, Hitler's second in command. Yeah, and the launch of the NHS psychiatry out of Hamilton, where my Auntie Anne's husband comes from. The honorary title allowed Rothschild to hang a shield decorated with the arms of the Hess and Hanau on the door of his house. So the green shield and the red, blood red Rothschild shield that becomes the blue shield for Israel. Yeah? And all the rest of the people live in poverty. By 1784, the family had grown to include Salomon, Isabella, Babette, Julie, and Henriette. Yeah? All of them jokes about chickens and eggs. Yeah, and salmon fishing in the Yemen, yeah, and the Babette and the baboons and all of the Isabella and Ferdinand and all of the religious cover-ups, all of the princes in the British royals in recent years are covers also for Prince Philip, and it is just a repeating cover story to try and ease the pain of what this family have done to our world. Every central bank is now owned by them. Okay, so Waltzing Matilda, this is the power base and the genealogical bloodlines that they are in that run the whole world. Okay, so this is the home in Frankfurt again, the Villa Grüneburg. The Villa Grüneburg was built on four acres of land in Amschel von Rothschild estate, which he had given to his niece and nephew Charlotte and Anselm. The style appears to have been Charlotte's choice, for in a letter in 1844 she wrote, "I am hesitating between the Elizabethan and the cottage style, as it is to be perfectly English." Yeah, these are the countries that lead us to war in 1939 and 1914. Do you get it? They fund all sides, they profit from all sides, yet all of their people are shielded in the inquests by body doubles, and Bomber Harris gets rid of the evidence that they are complicit in profiteering, yeah, and all of the things that happen that are portrayed in the Valkyrie movie, yeah, and Hitler is a Rothschild, Stalin is a Rothschild, and on it goes. Okay, the architects Bellinger and Jacob von Essen. Okay, the Essen bombings are legendary. The Essen Bible writings are legendary, and all of it is a fucking sick joke. Yeah, with its rich, and I think that's the bombing of Cologne in the Essen region, with its rich and decorative features, the villa showed allusions to both the Baroque architecture of southern Italy and the French Chateau of the Loire. Yeah, massive holdings all over Europe. The French ones I've not even gotten round to yet. Here's the Conigan story about the king, yeah, being subservient to them. Yeah, all the way through world history. When Anselm died, the house passed to his daughter Hannah Matilda and her husband Willie Carl. Yeah, all of the stories in popular culture, and the film I watched on the weekend about Indiana Jones and Willie, his blonde Aryan girlfriend, yeah, visiting India, which is entirely theirs. Yeah, entirely theirs. Konigsgen. Oh no, it's Konigstein, like the chef that travels the world. Yeah, and my wife is a great fan of Rick Stein. Yeah. And King is the Koningen's Asset Park in Belgium, which is the massive joke about the kings of Belgium and all of the democracy that is now the EU, with no king left in it. Believe that if you like. Yeah. And the Queenstown joke in New Zealand. New Zealand is totally abused by these people. Kingstown, Frankfurt. Again, Hannah Matilda and Willie, and it's Peel built. The architect this time has the pie words in his name. That's the pinstripe suits in the profiteering sector. Taurus in the vast parklands. Queen Vict opened them because their neighbours. Yeah, that is the South African joke, and all the German massive land holdings on the west coast of Southern Africa. Max is next in line in Frankfurt and the Munich Masons. So that is that is Max Rothschild, and that is the people that are the goldsmiths. He's Max Goldsmith. Okay, massive links to the Kemps of South Africa. Yeah, that is the bloodline that are married in to my uncle Gilbert and my auntie Anne's lineage, and they're going back to South Africa, and she gets massive childbirth issues when she has children. Yeah. Yeah, and that's the RSA banking dynasty and my treasonous, traitorous relatives from Melrose and Hamilton. They have heart attacks, diabetes and post-childbirth pain and rat-invested houses near Sandringham. Yeah,
God gives me all of the messages that I need. Yeah, and these are the people, yeah, that are unprepared to liaise with me, but they're best mates with my wife from Chipping Norton. That's how the power base work. It's called peer pressure. Gilbert, no trust, NHS, yeah, and he was an enemy of Deirdre Hutton, who was the head of the Borders Health Board and then became the